difference in how we view chronic deprivation on private land versus public land, where there are other values in place. And so that was the basis of my question. I understand you didn't actually support that philosophically. You want to explain?
No, I didn't. No.
Okay.
No, well, no, I could be, and the reason being is those cattle are our private property, much like your pickup. If you were to go to a parking lot on public land, it's not a free for all. That's not for public access or somebody to steal. Okay. We're legally there.
My experience with managing wolves, Greg, was it's very hard to really look at a linear population model. For example, the Druid Peak pack in Yellowstone was one of the largest packs, you know, 37 members. It crashed to 3 or 4 and it doesn't exist anymore. Part of that was disease and part of that was intra-specific competition between adjacent packs. And so when you get a large pack, which is large numbers, and you aggregate that in your thinking, and you look at a line, that can be a linear line, but then you can have something intervene. And I just think we need that flexibility in the plan to recognize that, as Jim said, we're not there yet in this state, but at some point, we're gonna have to recognize, particularly as some of these wolves run into canine and parvovirus and which and got to the Druid Peak Pack, that happened. So commissioners, any other